All right, so let's walk through setting up Kanna Protecc on an avatar that I would like to not be rippable. The written version of these instructions are on the Kanna Protecc GitHub. This is just me walking through it very quickly in a video form. All these same instructions are on the GitHub, but some of the images are a little out of date. First, a few things to know. In order for your avatar to be seen, your avatar has to be fully shown. Shaders, animations, everything. This is just how Kanna Protecc works, and it's a major caveat of this, and it's probably why a similar system hasn't been implemented by VRChat itself. This also will take up 32 bits of your parameter space, so if you're already close to the 256 parameters mark, you can reduce that to whatever's remaining. But that'll of course be less secure. And also, only shaders listed on that GitHub are supported, but some fairly common ones like Poyomi are on there. Once you have made a backup of your project, that's very important. This is a very invasive and destructive process, and it has the potential of breaking your project. If you do not make a backup, you will lose work. After you've made a backup, make sure you've got your compatible shader. I'm going to be using Poyomi shaders. And go ahead and download the antirip folder from the GitHub and import it. I've already done both of those steps. Next thing to do is to double check our FBXs. We want to make sure that the FBX, and if you just need a quick way to get to your FBX, if you click on your body skin mesh renderer, there's this little body mesh right there. You click on that, it'll open up whatever folder that's in. And then this right here is your FBX. When if you were to close that sort of expansion, this is your FBX file. You want to double check that read write is definitely enabled. Legacy blend shape normals is turned on, and the normals are set to import, not calculate. That all looks good. So next, I'm going to add the Kanna Protecc root script right on the root of my avatar, the same game object that has my VRC avatar descriptor. That's very important. It can't go on a random empty, it has to be here. Next thing to check, usually when you're uploading to VRChat, I think your animator component is supposed to be empty. I think that just prevents it from uploading your FX layer twice, but that's not a concern with Kanna Protecc, and Kanna Protecc actually requires that your FX layer that you're going to be encrypting be slotted into this controller slot on your animator component. Kanna Protecc also requires that for your menu and parameters that you have a parameter slot or parameter file loaded into the slot. For most bases and stuff that already come preset up, there will already be a parameter file here. If it's something you're making completely from scratch that might be empty, just make a new parameter object. And if this is an avatar that you are uploading a new version of, just go ahead and delete the old version from VRChat. And you can do that by going into your VRChat SDK content manager, and then on any of your avatars that you've uploaded, you can delete them. And if you are uploading this and it's an already existing avatar that you've now deleted, make sure to go into your pipeline manager and hit detach. This is a new avatar, so I do not have to do that. Next up, I've found sometimes with newer Poyomis that the Kanna Protecc auto locking can get stuck. I'm not sure why this happens, but just to be safe, go to each of your materials and make sure to lock them. Before we hit encrypt avatar, I want to explain a few of these fields. This is for any material that is included in an animation. So if I have a material swap animation, like I had a different body texture or any of those animations, I want to add them to the additional materials list here. This is just so that those materials are capable of decrypting the garbled mesh. Yeah, so these materials will be ignored. If a mesh contains other materials that are not ignored, it will still be encrypted. So if you have a material that would normally match a compatible material, but you would like for that mesh to be ignored, and as the only material on that mesh, you can add it to this list. And then last thing down here at the bottom, we have the ability to exclude objects from being renamed and excluding parameters from being renamed. The main reason you want to do this, especially with the parameters, is for anything that interacts with OSC. Any parameters that relies on OSC or contact names or anything like that, you're going to want to add to this exclude parameters from renaming just so that they still continue to function as normal. And all right, so if that's all good, I don't happen to have any of those in this instance, but once you've done all of that, you just hit encrypt avatar. All right, and if you have an absolutely crazy garbled ball of nonsense here, everything is working as intended, and this is basically ready to be uploaded. So notice that it's hidden everything except for my avatar with the appended name encrypted underscore obfuscated. This means that the mesh has been encrypted and all of the parameter names have been obfuscated. If you drop this down, you actually can see what it's done. It's made these sort of just random strings for everything, which just makes it a real pain in the ass, even more so than the mesh nonsense. So now we just want to upload this. Oh, and also, you know, correct anything like mipmap textures. So I'm just going to go ahead and build and publish this. Once it's uploaded, the last step is to write the keys to your to the local files. So we're actually going to copy this blueprint ID right here. Go back to the original Kanna Protecc component. And this pipeline manager right here, we're going to make sure to attach it to this avatar ID. This version should never be uploaded. This is the fully unencrypted avatar. And if I turn this on, you'll see as well the VRChat SDK doesn't want us to do it since it has the Kanna Protecc root, which is not a supported script on it. So never hit autofix and upload this because that will just negate the entire point of doing any of this. But since it's now attached, we can now hit write keys. Yep. And it'll give you that message. As long as you don't get any errors, this should now be done. Make sure that when you're doing that, VRChat is closed. Otherwise, it may prevent you from being able to actually write those keys to disk and actually allow you for your avatar to be decrypted. And yeah, the avatar is decoded and functioning normally and as expected in VRChat. To be able to edit your avatar again, the only thing you should need to do is hit unlock materials. And turn off the obfuscated version, turn on the original version. And there you go. You can make edits to this again. And once you're finished, just hit encrypt and then upload that. So the one thing that this doesn't do is anything to your textures. Your textures will still be uploaded as normal. And so if you're just using a regular old avatar base, those can still be taken from a ripped file and placed onto a non-encrypted mesh. I'm going to show you a way to mitigate that in the next video.